You're the best seat in the house there.
Yeah.
Thank you.
poets who lived out their lives on the first day of the Battle of the Somme, the 1st of July, 1916. Also all those who, in the course of the year, have given their lives in the service of their monarch and their country. Let us commend our thanks to God and pray. Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, you are great and greatly to be praised. We worship you because you are the creator of all things, the God of sovereign providence. But especially we worship you because of your great salvation. For in your mercy, you did not leave all humanity to perish in their condition of sin and misery, but freely provided and offered to sinners life and salvation through the mediator and the redeemer of you appointed, even the Lord Jesus Christ. It is in his name that we draw near and work in worship. And it is through his sacrifice, righteousness, and glory to the Lord that we are bold to come before your throne of grace. This evening, Father, we are told the sacrifice of so many who laid down their lives in the service of their country. Thank you for their service, their courage, and their selflessness. Thank you for the freedom which they secured for those coming after them. We ask you, Father, to give to our people the wisdom as they cast their vote manifestly. And Lord, in your mercy, give us a government which will preserve the liberties and privileges of our nation, one for us at such high cost. We pray you will bless our King. We pray that you will aid and speed his recovery to health and strength, and also the recovery of the Princess of Wales and the Princess Royal. Be with all the members of the Royal High School. We pray that you will protect all those who serve in the armed forces and the police force. Be with us in our undertaking this evening. May our actions promote your glory. For we ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let me read some verses from God's Word from John chapter 17, reading the first 6 verses and then verse 12. We are reading here words of a prayer which Jesus offered to his Father a few hours before he was put to death. And this is God's Word. When Jesus had spoken these words, he lifted up his eyes to heaven and said, Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son, that the Son may glorify you, since you have given him authority over all flesh, to give eternal life to all who you have given him. This is eternal life, that they know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. I glorified you on earth, having accomplished the work that you gave me to do. And my Father, glorify me in your own presence, with the glory that I had with you before the world existed. I have manifested your name to the people who you gave me out of the world. While I was with them, I kept them in their name which you have given me. I have guarded them, and not one of them has been lost, except the son of destruction, that the scripture might be fulfilled. Amen. May God bless his word. 108 years ago today, he was in a concentration trench, in the box of grenades to be distributed to the troops. box slipped down into the trench, which was crowded with men, and two of the safety pins fell in. Private McFadden instantly realized the danger to his colleagues, and with heroic courage, threw himself on top of the grave. He was killed in the ensuing explosion, but only one other man was injured. He knew well his danger, but without a moment's hesitation, he gave his life for his country, knowing that he could only save his comrades by acting quickly and by sacrificing his own life. McFadden did not hesitate. Jesus was praying those words to be read the night before he went to the cross. He came, you see, at his Father's command to deliver his people from the consequences of sin by taking his guilt on himself and dying in our place on the cross. He could only save his people by sacrificing his own life. In his prayer that night, he was able to say, "Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son, that the Son may glorify you." You see, it was by his death in the place of his people that he would deliver them from sin and bring them into God's salvation. And thereby, he would bring glory to God. Early on the next morning, the morning following the assault at the Somme, after taking part in the attack on the 1st of July, a man from Wishville, the Strangle Man Robert Quinn, serving with the close battalion of the Royal Irish Regiment, Greg Michael, heard a rumor that his platoon commander, Sir Harry McDonald, was lying wounded in Roland's Land. Quick left his trench, and under heavy shell fire, mortar, and machine gun fire, which the Times was actually claimed on him, he went out to search for that weapon. Quick went out several times, and each time he brought back a wounded man, dragging the last of the waterproof sheets from within a few yards of the enemy's barbed wire. After those seven attempts, which took him 7 hours, he was so exhausted that his officers wouldn't let him go out again. Robert Quick rescued wounded men by doing something for them which they could not do for themselves. They were so disabled by their injuries that they could only lie where they had fallen. They couldn't get themselves back to the trenches. Quick brought them to safety. Now, while he brought 7 men to safety, and that was a magnificent achievement, he could not find the one man that he had sent out initially to look for. Jesus, in his prayer, says that he will not fail to find everyone that he came to earth to save. He will seek everyone, he will call everyone to receive and rest on him through faith alone as Savior. That's what he prayed. "While I was with them, I kept them in your name, which you have given me. I have guarded them, and not one of them has been lost, except the son of destruction, that the scripture might be fulfilled." Brethren, friends, this evening, Jesus, who came into this world and gave his life to rescue us from sin, is calling you. He is calling you with his Holy Spirit to come to him and to find all of God's salvation.
Thank you.